I am Anders Hagstrom with the Daily Caller, and with me today is Alfredo Ortiz. He is the president and CEO of the Job Creators Network. Thanks so much for coming on.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me. I appreciate that.
Yeah, and obviously your organization is devoted to fighting for free enterprise in America, and it's a really tough time for free enterprise in America right now amid coronavirus and everything. Can we talk a little bit about, obviously the numbers seem to change every single time you go to look at them. We're having more and more unemployment claims. The economy is going into the dumps. Where does the economy stand right now?
Yeah, right now the economy is not looking good because of the coronavirus. Again, remember, and what really is horrible about all of this is just a couple weeks ago, I should say about 6-7 weeks ago, right? We had one of the best economies ever, record low unemployment, record employment across all demographic groups. Unemployment was looking fantastic. We had 7+ million unfilled jobs. And then boom, the COVID crisis hit us. And within a matter of 7 weeks, just today, you can see the job report number, 20+ million jobs, 15% unemployment. And I'm going to tell you right now, we got to hold our hats because it's going to get worse before it does get better. Unfortunately, when you look at the jobless claims that are weekly coming out, they're at 30 million. So this is what we saw today. The job report is a little bit of a lagging data point. So starting next week, we're going to start seeing these numbers look horrific, actually, at one point. And they are going to be worse than the Great Depression, I believe. Mm-hmm. But having said all that, we're putting the plans in place. We're starting to open up slowly but surely. I think what people are finding out, though, that you can shut everything down overnight, but you can't bring it up overnight. It's almost impossible to do that.
Mm-hmm. And so let's talk a little bit about how we can go about reopening, because obviously the U.S. government has spent trillions and trillions of dollars in trying to give a lifeline to these businesses.
Yeah.
So should we be investing more in that? Should there be a phase four bill? I know that that's been buzzing around Congress.
Right. Yeah. I mean, when you think about what we've done overall from a congressional standpoint, about $3 trillion has already been put into the economy. About $4 trillion on the balance sheet from the Fed. So we've already put in $7 trillion. The reality is you can't keep floating a $22 trillion GDP economy much longer. We've got to put people back to work. We've got to get these businesses back and running. And frankly, we got to get consumers buying again. Remember, this was an economy that's 70% consumer driven. And so if consumers aren't feeling comfortable, and we've seen some of the consumer confidence indices at some of the lowest points they've been in years at this point, if we can't get the consumer to go back out and keep, purchasing and getting out there again, it's going to be a really, really rough ride. So, right now the government has done what it needed to do, which is it pitched in. It was able to keep some of the payrolls going. But now industry has to get in there. Industry has to really drive how these protocols are going to come together, by industry, but then also collectively, because I think collectively they should all be focused on the consumer at this point. Of course, the employees as well, but the consumer really is going to what's going to drive the return of this economy.
Mm-hmm. So recently, the former FDA director Scott Gottlieb he tweeted about essentially how the in order to reopen safely, there needs to be, in his opinion, a CDC guideline, essentially a blanket guideline for the entire country for every industry, in order to allow those companies to not be afraid of lawsuits, that kind of thing, in the process of reopening. Do you think that responsibility should fall on the CDC, or do you think that the private sector can be trusted to do that for itself?
Yeah, great question. I do not think the CDC should get involved from that perspective. It should not be the one that actually develops the guidelines, because government doesn't run business. Business runs business. And so what I think it should have is the blessing, for example, of the CDC or another body. So, for example, I'm not sure if people realize this, but a lot of the products that we have at home, for example, are blessed what's called by Underwriters Laboratory, for example, or a Good Housekeeping Seal of Approval, right? They're third-party groups that have agreed upon protocols to make sure that our products that we consume or we use every day are safe. I think that's what we should be doing, but it needs to be done by industry, developed by industry. Here's a great example. Movie theaters, for example, if you left it up to government would probably say, hey, take those chairs and put them 6 feet apart. There's your solution. It would be a really bad date night, right? If you had to sit 6 feet away from your date on a date night, right? May come. Industry may say, hey, I've got these headlights overhead, they're UVs. Maybe what we do is let's go ahead and put UV lights in there and we'll zap the movie theater before, between each showing. That would be the industry solution. Those are the kind of things that we need industry to collectively come and create that standardization that's going to be needed, and then get that message out to the consumers. That's how this is going to be done.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned workers a little bit earlier and their interests sort of against the consumer. There, you've seen a lot of strikes from Amazon employees, yeah. other major companies saying that they should even, calling for boycotts even. Do you think that they have a point? What do you think their motivations are for what they're calling for?
So call me a little, this is a little bit of the typical left doing what they do best, which is boycotts. But when you look at the companies, they know that really at the end of the day for them, the most valuable asset that they have is their employees, right? And so they are going to do whatever is possible. The problem is just the speed at which this all happened is overwhelming, right? And if you've got 10, 50, 100, 200, 300,000 employees, right, it's quite a system that you need to all basically overhaul overnight. And so I think it's getting there. I'm sure business, I mean, having come from, I've worked at a large company as well, I know that they're not sitting there going, let's think of all the different ways that we can really harm our employees. I think simultaneously, they're also trying to stay alive themselves in terms of as a company, because revenue has completely stopped everywhere. And so again, this is a pandemic and this is a crisis, I think, unlike anything we have seen in our lifetime at this point. And I just pray to God that we never see something like this again.
Mm-hmm. Well, to lighten things up, last question here. I ask this to everybody who comes on. But obviously, we're all stuck in home. Everybody, almost every single American, basically. So what have you been doing to keep yourself from going crazy?
Yeah, I have to tell you, honestly, like my team and I, we've been working 25/7. I mean, this is such an important issue, such a crisis that we're all in emergency mode. I don't think many of us have done much to really relax. Maybe some Netflix like everybody else. But outside of that, this team's working hard to try to make sure our small business owners and, quite frankly, the entire American economy survive.
All right. Well, Alfredo Ortiz, thank you so much for coming on, CEO and president of the Job Creators Network. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.